Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you are a new subscriber, welcome and thank you for joining my beautiful family. And if you are a returning supporter, a regular, regular, a day one, honey, welcome back. And thank you so much for your support. It is truly, truly, truly appreciated. If you're not subscribed, you might as well subscribe right now using this button right here and click the notifications bell so you're notified every single time your girl uploads a new video. My name is Mhlani Damase and in today's video, I am going to be doing a Louis Vuitton unboxing. I'm so excited. I'm sure you guys can tell by the grin on my face that this is like such a hallelujah moment for me. So I am a huge fan of luxury. I'm a huge fan of designer. Anybody who's been following me knows that I'm a designer whore and I am not new to designer items. I have quite the collection. I wouldn't say it's the biggest, certainly not, but I do have quite a few pieces, but I've never filmed anything luxury for my channel before, simply because I've never really been comfortable putting my purchases out there. A lot of people can have negative reaction towards you unboxing luxury items online. It comes off as though you're showing off or whatever the case may be, but I found that there is definitely a market for that. There are people who appreciate such, and I have first-hand experience. I'm definitely someone who wanted to do my research before purchasing any luxury item. I probably watched a million Christian Louboutin unboxing Sokade videos, as well as how to walk in them, and you know, if people found them worth it or not before purchasing my first pair, which was my first ever designer item. So hopefully this video can come in handy for someone who's looking into making their first purchase, or just someone who is looking to add another piece into their collection. So if you are interested in this video, then please do keep on watching. So I'm manifesting, right? I am manifesting that one day I can say thank you so much to Louis Vuitton for sponsoring this video, or thank you so much to Louis Vuitton for sponsoring my trip to New York Fashion Week. So we are just manifesting, honey, but as of now we will just continue buying and supporting, and hopefully they come across the channel and one day they decide to work with the girl. So the handbag I got from Louis Vuitton is the Cannes Reverse Monogram handbag, which is part of the Reverse Monogram collection. It is also known as the Cannes bag. By the way, I'm not an expert at luxury unboxings. I'm not an expert at pronouncing French or whatever language Louis Vuitton names are. So if you are someone who's finicky about that, please don't judge. Just bear with me. This is my first ever luxury unboxing, so I will get into the hang of things. But I'm going to try to do it to the best of my ability, and hopefully you guys can take something from the video, and hopefully it'll influence you to purchase something LV, get some vitamin C during this pandemic, because it's very important. Okay, so first and foremost, this is what the box looks like. It is quite the big box for the bag, I won't lie, because the bag is not that big. But anyway, they put it in this box. So first and foremost, the bag does come with a duster bag, which looks like this. By the way, the box was nicely wrapped when I purchased the bag. It came with this ribbon, but obviously I've removed it already because when I got home, I was like, I need to see my bag. So yeah, this is the duster bag, standard Louis Vuitton duster bag, which opens like this. It doesn't have a drawstring. And this is the receipt. And you can also see, I'm not going to show you guys too much, obviously, because I don't want you guys to have my address. But yeah, this is the receipt over here, which has details of price and everything. The bag does retail for 40,000 Rand. The first time I laid my eyes on the bag was in January, beginning of this year, and I wanted it from the get-go. But I didn't purchase it because I'm the kind of person who, before I make a luxury item purchase, especially something that I feel like is quite the steep price, I like to first sleep on it and let the item haunt me. So I saw the bag the day before I flew back to Joburg. I was in Cape Town for a bit of a holiday. I flew to Joburg the following day, and then in that week I was like, oh my gosh, I need that bag. I can't stop thinking about it. I got to the Louis Vuitton here in Sandton and they were like, the bag is sold out. We don't have stock. We'll have to call you when we restock. They didn't restock for months, and only recently they were like, okay, we have the bag in stock. And I was like, I have to get it, because it's literally been haunting me. Like every time I think summer vacation, white dress, beach, I just think this bag. It's perfect, perfect, perfect. So I was like, I need this bag. So I'm quite a huge fan of Louis Vuitton, just to give you guys a bit of a background why I love the brand and why I'd recommend it, seeming as though this is an unboxing, so you guys should have like sufficient information on why I support the brand so much. I am a huge, huge, huge LV fan. I love how a lot of their bags are classics. You can literally purchase an item from LV at the age of 25, and it's something you could probably also carry at the age of 35, because their items are so versatile. They literally multi-talented. They are the multi-talented, as some people would say. You know, the bags you can dress up and down. A lot of them have removable straps, so if you purchase a small little cute bag, it has a strap that you can use to carry cross body, and then it also has an attached strap that you can carry when you want to make the bag look a little bit formal. But you guys will see with this specific item. In terms of pricing as well, they have very good entry-level designer bags, such as your Neverfull. I'm a huge, huge fan of that. What an amazing purchase for someone who's getting their first designer bag. That was actually my first designer bag as well. Excellent quality. They age extremely. That's one thing that I love about Louis Vuitton handbags, is that they age so well. You notice that with some of the bags, when you purchase them, the straps are an extremely light cream color, and then as it ages, it turns into a tan. And I personally feel like the straps look better once the bag has aged. Let me show you guys my beautiful, beautiful handbag. How stunning is she? I am obsessed. So this is what the bag looks like. As I said before, it is part of the Reverse Monogram collection. So you have the darker side over here at the top, and then the lighter side all the way around. As you guys can see, the shape of the bag, it does have a side with black leather. This allows you to rest the bag on your body, because the shape can be extremely difficult to carry. You don't want your bag to be spinning around as you're carrying it. So this side really allows the bag to rest nicely against your body. The bag does have gold hardware, and every single place that there's gold hardware, it is engraved LV, Louis Vuitton, LV, Louis Vuitton. It also has a lock over here, just like most Louis Vuitton bags have. I won't say all, because I do think that some of them don't have this lock, like the Neverfull, for example. So yeah, it has this beautiful lock over here, which is also engraved LV. And inside the handbag, there is a little pouch which has the key. So if you are really interested in locking your bag, then you can make use of that feature. So this is an adjustable strap. It also rotates, so you don't have to worry about how you put it on, because you can just move it around while it's on your body. It is detachable. So as you guys can see, this is how it looks without the strap. This is black leather as well, by the way, which also is adjustable according to your height or your body size. It just helps you wear the bag comfortably. So this is what the bag looks like without the adjustable strap, which I think is very, very cute. Why I say I love the brand so much is that it gives you freedom to dress the bags up or down. This is something that you could wear with a cute little black dress to dinner. And then if you add the strap, you could wear it with a tracksuit while you're running errands. It also has gold hardware 4 feet at the bottom over here. I think this is also just something that will help protect your leather in the long run as you place your bag on various surfaces. The leather is also textured, so it isn't smooth at all, which I feel like gives the bag a lot of personality. And then there's this beautiful little leather flap over here, which is written Louis Vuitton Paris. And if you lift the flap, you can sort of see when your bag was made. So mine was made on the 32nd week of 2020. And it has FL. I'm not sure where FL is, but I'll just leave all those details down here, because you can also check where your bag was made. So I think that is it for the details on the outside. Just like I said, black leather trimming everywhere. So now we're moving on to the inside of the handbag. The one thing I would say is a con about this bag is that it is a bit flimsy, maybe, because if you are standing and there's no surface to put your bag down and you need to pay for something quickly, if you open your bag, you could risk dropping a couple of things. So that's the only con I would probably say I have, but otherwise everything else is a pro. Okay, so in here there's another leather patch sewn on, and this also says Louis Vuitton Paris, made in France. Yes, so my bag was made in France. And then there are no compartments, no pockets, no nothing. It is just beautiful black suede material in the bag. It is quite deep. I watched a couple of reviews actually. Sorry, I keep on looking at my monitor instead of the screen because I want to make sure that you guys can see everything and everything's in focus. I did watch a couple of reviews and a lot of people said that the bag is... It can hold quite a lot, which I'm yet to try out. I haven't carried the bag at all, but I do believe that because it is actually quite deep inside, you would look at it thinking that it's quite a small bag. As much as it is a small bag, I think it can really accommodate a lot. So if you are someone who's finicky about having your things in compartments, you could probably try and compartmentalize the bag yourself. Yeah, it's really, really beautiful. And if you are someone who's obsessed or familiar with designer, you'll understand why, you know, purchasing a luxury item means so much. And just like the craftsmanship and everything, the detail that they put into making sure that everything is perfect, literally absolutely perfect. If you spot a certain fault on your bag, you are definitely welcome to exchange it. They allow you to exchange it in store, but I've never had that experience. Everything is always very, very perfect and precise. Just even small things like them using black cotton on the black leather part, as well as a nude on the monogram surface, which is really, really, really stunning. I don't know if I gave you guys price details, but this bag does retail for 40,000 rand. When I first spotted it, which was in January this year, it was going for 38,000 rand, so there was definitely an inflation. So if you want to purchase it, I suggest you get it soon. Otherwise, you might be paying 45k for it. And you know these designer brands, and they don't play. They don't play when it comes to inflating prices, honey. I promise you, they do not play. So this is it if you're wearing it as a crossbody. So, so, so stunning. I'm absolutely obsessed. So can you see how the flat side just rests so nicely against your body? And it doesn't really move around much, whereas if it was round all the way, then it would probably be twisting and turning while you're busy trying to get things done. So I really appreciate this detail about it. And I think it also just helps you not stain your bag. Sometimes you'll find that if you purchase an all nude bag, you'll find that over time the color does get stained or change color, especially if you're someone who wears jeans and whatnot. So I think it was extremely smart of them to add the black leather to the belt, because this also just helps protect your bag. So I hope I've given you guys enough information on this item, but if you guys need any additional information, you can check out the Louis Vuitton website. There are a few details on things like the material, which is calf leather trim, the height and the width of the bag, if you are someone who's extremely finicky just to see all that stuff. But yeah, I've tried to touch on everything. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed my first luxury unboxing video. I feel like this was very short. But anyway, my loves, thank you so much for tuning in. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And let me know how you guys feel about luxury unboxings. Is it something that I should do often when I purchase luxury items? Or is it something that you're not necessarily interested in? Just let me know down below in the comment section. Don't forget to give this video a very big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will see you guys next time. Stay blessed and beautiful. Mwah!